I'm here with Julie Bettosini, and we're here today to show you this lovely home in the Lake Nona area. It's absolutely gorgeous, amazing floor plan, and we're going to get started and tell everybody about this, because I love this house.
Yes, I do too. First of all, I love Lake Nona. We have been working down here since 2006, in the beginning of Medical City, when this was just kind of a blip on the map, and before all these exciting projects got started. So to actually be in this house, on the water, in new construction, fast forward, it's just, I honestly can't believe I'm looking out at Lake Nona right now in a house that has come to fruition on a piece of property that's been here for a while. So it is really a happy moment to be here with you and talk about one of my favorite houses, and more importantly, probably my favorite project that you guys have done in terms of staging, really.
Well, I love the way this house turned out as well. I love the pillows. We're talking about how well everything looks like with the backsplash. And there are a lot of materials in this house that are really unique and special.
I think so too. I mean, when we first came here, when it was in the process of being designed, the selections that the builder and the designer made were just, you know, beyond, they weren't too trendy. They were really just right here at the moment, current, but bringing the warmth in of color. And then when we talked about staging this house, the builder had talked about doing some virtual staging.
Right.
And obviously it can be easy, and it's not the same process of bringing in all of this. And I really tried to share with them that the impact would just not be the same when people came through the front door, that the photos online might look great, but the reality is when they come in the door, you still want that wow.
It's a wow factor. It's a feeling you get when you come in, and you can't get that one. You can't get the whole feeling online. And you know, we do offer that service for special situations, but usually it's if the house needs some partial remodeling, that we can show rendering. This is what it could look like. Mm-hmm. These are some ideas. Or if the house is so far away, so out in the boonies that you don't get very many showings, then that might be a good candidate for it. But for most people, especially a house of this caliber, people expect it to look like this. And it's funny because, you know, we're always keeping up on the new staging statistics, and there's a new one that came out that people are expecting a higher level of staging because of watching all these television shows. All these shows on HGTV, you know, they show this level of staging that is, it's getting better and better and better. And so when they're looking at homes, they want it to look like that. They don't want just everybody's, you know, which is funny because we used to just rearrange what people already had and maybe supplement a few things here or there just to make, you know, try to save money too. But the level is just what their expectations are higher.
And mine has changed from the agent perspective because we've been working together forever. And so it started with remodeling, moving around bookshelves and making things look beautiful and adding in. And like you said, moving around the furniture that people already had. And now we sit down in a client meeting and say, do you want to give it a 10 out of 10 in order to sell your house? And if they say yes, and oftentimes we're talking about complete staging projects, whether it's brand new construction like this or even an existing home, because that's really putting their best foot forward, is to clean the palette, bring it all in, make it like it really is a model home, even if it's a home that's 10 years old. And so my perspective has changed from a selling side, is that it's a must, and it's in every home no matter what, and it's just which part of it. Is it going to be virtual because they just added a room, or because they're not prepared to change the countertops and the cabinets yet? So do we just emphasize that one room in virtual? We stage the other rooms, you know? So I think every house today, don't you, need some form of staging?
Everything. Yeah, absolutely. And I think, you know, we're talking about homes over the years. There's a home recently I went to on Saturday that I actually staged back in 2004 or 5. And I wouldn't use any, even though it was high-end staging furniture, I wouldn't use anything in this house that I used back then because the trends have changed so much.
Right.
And so even though they have high-end furniture in there now, we are moving everything out of that house. And it's a gigantic house. and we are painting everything because it's too dark. You know, people want lighter and brighter. And it doesn't, and on Mediterranean, I usually don't go this white, but you know, like a more modern home like this one, you can. But you know, it's still in the warm palettes, and then we decorate it, and it just looks It looks much newer. It looks like that new, the new Mediterranean, the new California Mediterranean that people still love.
Yeah.
Yeah, that really never goes out of style.
So what do you do? So what do you do with all the old furniture? I mean, what happens to all that?
We just took a couple of truckloads of our personal furniture to Primrose, but there's lots of great charities in the area that are always looking for furniture. So that's what we do, and I mean, it's still good, gently used. Just, you know, it's really hard. People want this look when you're
right.
And it just depends how you know, how fast you want to sell your house. If you want to get top dollar and you want to sell it fast, you just have to go the extra mile. And not to say everybody needs to. Some people have some classic pieces that we maybe can accessorize with lighter pillows and bring it up. Just every house is unique, different.
Well, I love the charity aspect that you actually give back, and you're always so charitable in so many ways around town. So it's just another form of what you do in this community. So that is awesome.
The only way I can swallow it. Like, I hate that I have to get rid of all my furniture, but we have to over a few years just because
trends change.
The trends change, and nobody wants these big, heavy sectionals that we used to put in living rooms. Now they want a nice, simple seating arrangement with more space. We don't use all the big end tables anymore, and they just want it very clean, very clean lines. And you know, they say 40% of the buyer's agents will say that people want to see a stage home.
Right.
That's how that they are used to seeing that. That's what they want. So you just have to keep some of those.
Don't you think they expect it now after all of, you know, whether it's HGTV or house, they are now walking in wanting more complete. I mean, a couple of years ago, people said, oh, they want to imagine their own furniture there, but they really want to imagine something that they aspire to decorate their home like,
right, you know? It's a lifestyle.
And so, and many people can't pull it off and have the talent and skill set that you guys do to be able to actually go into a home without the help of a professional to do it. So then they walk in, and how often have we put deals together that they've bought the staged furniture and wanted to keep it exactly as is after seeing it? I mean, we've done that countless times.
Right, we're happy to do that. And that's, yes, it's all, everything's for sale.
But I would say when I walked in here, when this was finished, we walked in, I looked at these pillows, I looked at the backsplash, I looked at the island colors, and I was like, they have nailed it. And I called your team up and I was like, this is probably one of the prettiest, most detailed. Now, the product that you have to work with, I have to say, is pretty darn nice.
Well, so, yeah, when we get to work in a house like this, we really want to show everything else off in the house. I mean, the ceiling detail, the fixtures, there's nothing that they didn't take full advantage of. I mean, just beautiful details. So we want our furniture to look nice, but also blend in. I mean, you could have bar stools that just were wow here, but we really wanted to put something because the backsplash is a wow. Mm-hmm. We wanted to bring in bar stools that blend in, and you know, and same with the dining room. You've got all these details, ceiling details. So we wanted the chairs to blend in. We want things to, you know, look nice, but not be overwhelming because the house itself is so beautiful. The woodwork. I mean, really, I really, really, really love the materials that they used in this house, and it's a great floor plan.
It is. Yeah. It checks all the boxes. You're a few minutes from the airport. You're right near 5 minutes to Medical City. You can jump on the expressway if you work downtown. You don't have to be in Lake Nona this is the best value on the lake in this part of town. You can't get touch new construction for, you know, I would say you're going to get double the price anywhere else.
So the boat dock would be right there?
Boat dock is right out here. Okay. There's a shared boat dock, so there's each two houses that align this whole Lake Nona. It was just finished last week. So, and the lake is so underutilized. All of that on the other side is conservation. There's barely any boats. It's like your own private lake out here.
Right. Yeah, I've really never seen anybody out there, but it's so pretty to look at anyway.
No,
it absolutely. Like to look at the lake, right? And I love the way you look at the pool and the lake. So it's really pretty, the natural preserve in between.
When we talked about the trends changing, I was looking at a house that you staged a year ago, and I was looking at the photos, and I was thinking, well, if we're going to go back in and restage it now, do they change that quickly?
We actually even refresh homes. Now, you know, most homes sell within a few months, and statistically, it's, you know, again, it's half the amount of time staged as it would be or not staging it. But there are some examples where our price point, like a lot of times, the home is just so, it's just a small percentage of people can afford a house that big. A lot of times, they'll stay on the market a lot longer. So we actually will, every once in a while, we'll go in and refresh it because you know, you always want it to look fresh. And in some, even if the accessories aren't out of style, mm-hmm. I just sometimes want to make some little tweaks to it to,
right.
you know, spruce it up.
And this one in particular, they staged for a very short period of time. Right. And so it got the wow factor for the photos, but it lacked the ability to continue to have people feel the same way as they would feel when they come in this home.
Right.
And have, you know, all of this nice furniture upon arrival. Instead, it kind of is a little bit of a letdown.
Right.
And so I would say, from my perspective, I'm sure you would agree, that keep the staging in. It doesn't matter how long the home is on the market, even if it exceeded the average time on market for whatever reason, it's super important to keep that staging in until you've got a buyer and you're under contract, wouldn't you?
Oh, absolutely. And 83% of buyer's agents say that their buyers want to see a house staged. They relate to it better. Mm-hmm. They can visualize living there. So if most people are expecting it and they want it, why not keep it? Because mm-hmm. it is tougher to sell an empty home. Of course, an empty home of this caliber is easier to sell than an empty home that, you know, needs a lot of work.
Right.
But, you know, so every house has its unique qualities. But a house like this, I mean, it's just, it, like you said, 10 out of 10.
Mm-hmm.
And the 10 out of 10s always sell a lot faster than 5.
Right. And now, like I said, and as the years pass and as your business changes, so does our presentation to our sellers,
right.
and our ability to help them, whether it's a combination of virtual, regular staging, making sure it stays in the home. I mean, we truly are changing with you,
right.
To help these sellers, you know, get, like you said, top dollar, shortest time on the market with the least amount of headaches is really, you know,
right.
the goal.
Yep.
And you're an awesome partner to
well, thank
make
you.
That
appreciate,
happen, and I couldn't
appreciate
be
working with you.
More excited about the way that this one turned out.
Well, thank you. I don't think this one will be on the market very long, so
I don't either. I do not either.
That's
I do
beautiful.
Not either.
Well, thank you for joining us today, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.
Thank you, Megan. This one really...